Welcome again, Kelvin. I didn't introduce you because we don't need
to. It's okay.
We already did that. So, Kelvin, a lot of the newer realtors are looking for leads to jumpstart their business. What is your take on this?
Leads. Yes. We all want leads. We would love our phone to keep ringing all the time. But I think naturally, when you think of leads, people gravitate toward online leads. It seems easy. It does cost money. But don't forget that you can get leads from your network. And I think Shar touched upon it a lot, and a lot of the agents talked about it today. Leads can come from your network, referrals. It takes a lot more work, but those leads are stronger, a lot more stronger.
And I just wanted to make sure that you didn't have anything else to add.
Because I could keep going, but I feel like we're short on time.
I heard the hesitation. I was like,
Just cut me off if you have to. I know we're short on time, so I'm just.
Yeah, no, it's okay. We could say that it's your fault we're behind, but I'm not going to blame you. I'm just kidding.
Okay. Yeah. Wait. Yeah. No. So it's I think.
Let's go to the next question then, Kelvin. What are your expectations for online leads, huh? Well, how do you can you rely on that to grow your business, or what are your thoughts?
I think it keeps you busy. So back to the first question, for the newer agents, it's easy to, they want to feel busy. We all want to feel busy, but at that point, when you first start growing your business, you think that you don't have a referral base, but you actually do. You just don't spend the time on it. Well, what does that mean? Well, I mean, Shar mentioned you got to reach out to every single person in your network. I guarantee no one's done that, even myself, every single person. I mean, if you do that, I personally guarantee you get, if you do that today, I personally get 5 leads tomorrow. That's how simple it is. Those will come. But yes, online leads, what do you expect? Okay. It's nice to have that flow. I think from what I experienced myself, because I've gone through all those channels when I first started to. Mm-hmm. No more than 5% conversion rate, you know, and it really, I use it as an opportunity to perfect my pitch. I already know that 1 out of 20 may convert. So that in 19, they're not qualified. I know that going into the game. So if you're going to do that, be prepared. So what did I do? I really took it as an opportunity to speak to every single one. And I know that I won't hang up if they're not qualified, because I know that I'm confident that person I'm talking to, even though they're not qualified, that they know someone in their network that is qualified to buy or sell this year. So if I gain that trust, I spend that 5-10 minutes to get to know them, to build a relationship, add them to my CRM, reach out to them from time to time, they'll be thankful that I helped them. And down the road, when they hear, hey, I need a realtor, they're gonna remember, oh, this guy, he spent the time to actually educate me, help me along the way, even though I wasn't qualified.
Love it. So what are some of the top online lead generation platforms, Kelvin?
The first one that comes to mind is Zillow. You know, they've been around for a while. And it's, they have a corner for that market. I mean, I subscribed that in the past. And if you want to, entertain that, it is pretty costly. To be effective, you have to spend over $1,000 to lock in a zip code. And again, expect only 5% conversion rate. But when you get those calls, you got to really act on it fast. Because it's you know, in this day and age, they want information quickly. So you got to be there ready to pick up the phone or answer the questions right away and strike up the conversation, hopefully gain some trust. With that, I think the biggest, what you want to do is with Zillow, if you do want to go that route, make sure you beef up your Zillow reviews. I think Priscilla talked about reviews. Reviews are huge, right? It's underrated, but it's huge. Actually, hold on 1 second.
With that, he's got a lead gen, you guys. He's got a convert right now. No, I'm just kidding. So, well, he's gonna be there for a second while he does that. I guess that's my cue, right, guys? Hold on, it's my cue to share something while we're waiting.
Yeah, give me a second.
Nope. That's the life of a broker owner, guys. So if you had any other questions, now you know what you got to do. But while we're doing that, hopefully this doesn't interfere with this phone call. We're going to talk about, look, this is what you guys are going to be bringing in your business if you're successful. This is one of my favorite songs. I think it's also just a really good measure of what we're doing. You should have skipped ahead.
Just a young girl with a quick fuse. I was uptight, wanna let loose. I was dreaming.
I don't know how long Kelvin's gonna be gone. I feel like I'm supposed to take over, but I can't do that.
Not a yes, sir. Not a follower. Hit the box with the moan. Have a seat
for you. Take a number. Well, you got into our song now.
No, I'm just listening.
That's what your agents bring, right? They bring the thunder.
Oh, I love Imagine Dragons.
Awesome. Well, all your agents bring the thunder, right? That's what the thunder and the lightning, right?
Yeah, no, I love that song. Thank you. I feel like I need to step up and grab a mic and start singing karaoke.
I love it. I've all been deprived of karaoke for a long time, so you've probably got a lot of people in here that want to do that. All right, so back to our conversation, man. We were talking about online lead generation platforms, and I think you were moving into the part where leads generally cost money, so why don't agents just focus on getting referrals?
Ooh. Sorry, I got distracted.
That's okay.
Say that one time. I'm actually texting someone, and someone's coming through my house, and I want to.
Full disclosure, Kelvin wasn't prepared to share at the end of the day. It was supposed to be somebody else, and he was just going to wrap up with closing remarks, and so he's.
No, it's good.
No, it's okay.
I have a contractor coming by, and I just wanted to set him off before.
Transparency. People like. Okay. We'll tell them the truth, but okay. So the question was: since online leads generally cost money, why don't people just focus on getting referrals more?
I think I mentioned earlier, it's easier to, mm-hmm. to people. Okay. We all say that as if you want to build your business, you got to put in some hard work, some energy. But let's be real. We all want to take the easy path. So it wouldn't be nice. You wake up and your phone ring and great, you know, it's, you have another lead. I think it comes down to effort. It's okay to start with that, to start getting the leads to get you going. To feel that momentum, because I think a lot of times we need that little boost. But if you see anybody else growing their business, or you talk to the top producers at the end of the day, how many of them are actually buying leads online? Virtually zero. Yeah, it's just at that point in time, you set a business correctly, so the leads are actually coming from your network, right? So yes, start. If you want to start with the lead generation online, but at the end of the day, don't forget about your network, because that is where your network is your net worth. So that's where you really got to focus your time on.
Absolutely. Well, we've beaten a dead horse with this, but we're going to ask you this last question: how an agent sets themselves up to maximize their referral business?
Okay, so. It's a multi-step process, but with social media, it's free, like Perry said. It's you have to utilize that. So multi-part process. Okay, what do you do first? To be repetitive, yes. What Shara said, reach out to every single person you know, and that's a must. I mean, it's repetitive, but it's a must. And what I always recommend is in the very beginning, if any new realtors out there, you would tie that announcement that you just got your license with an event. When things were open back, you know, last year, we would host a launch party. I think Priscilla did one at Oakland office on the rooftop. So that's a good example we can do. You use the event and you reach out to your network. Hey, I got my license. Come celebrate with me. Now with the COVID times, you can modify the event a little bit. It could be a seminar. It could be a talk like this. It could be something about you sharing about the opportunities in the area, whatever it may be. So, but utilize an event is like a call to action. So when you reach out to someone, they'll have a reason to connect back if they're not available to chat at the moment. So reach out to people for sure. Add them to your some type of monthly newsletter, whether it's an email newsletter or if it's a paper newsletter. And don't forget the good old school paper newsletter, because emails can get in, it's free, it gets into your inbox, but some of us don't read it. Actually, a lot of us don't, because you see a lot of spam, right? But if you send out a monthly paper newsletter, a paper brochure, they're gonna look at it, because everyone loves getting mail. So send that off. Again, with social media, make sure you connect with everyone in your network on social media, because not everyone will see your email, and maybe to throw away your paper newsletter, But on social media, as you post, and there's ways to engage, right? So you want to touch, you want to get in front of them in that way. And the last piece, which I think is the most important is having a consistent plan on reaching out to your network and your whole network. Most of us, maybe we try to stay connected, maybe and more comfortable with like people that we know, our top 50 contacts or like our top 100 friends. But you got to go beyond that. You got to go beyond that. And the beauty of social media again is it allows you to connect almost effortlessly. You can just strike up a conversation, comment effectively. You know, just I share with our associates, just go through the feed and sit on that feed and don't leave that post until you find something really, you know, productive to say. You know, I mean, great to have an emoji, but let's try to start a conversation. And I think that what I always did and encourage is to always have a reason to reach out. If you see a post, everyone needs help, so everyone needs acknowledgement. So just feel that, right? They post something for a reason. Just okay, let's comment a little further. But everyone needs help with something, and I always share with agents, you gotta be there to help out people in your network. But the last bit I wanna leave is just that I've always had this, I've had this background with the out-of-state investment seminar. So when you talk to people, and I'll get back to that, when you're talking to people and you reach out to people, a lot of, it's very easy to just talk about real estate, like. And when you talk to the coaches out there, like just call people up, and sometimes with the scripts, they're pretty forward and aggressive. Like, hey, you know anyone that wants to buy or sell? Hey, when you buy and when you sell? No, I mean, I don't think they want to hear that from you. You know, there's a time and place for that. But the reason I was fortunate to have a background in the out-of-state investments, so I actually use that as a way in to invite them to these opportunities, because I'm getting into the mindset of the person I'm speaking to. What do they want to hear? They don't want me here. They don't want to hear me talk about buying and selling, because they either can't afford it or they bought or sell already. So what else can I do? Well, I always go in with like, I want to help them retire early. I want to help them get out of rat race. I want to help them invest. So if you come with that, that's just one idea. If you come in with something else, something to offer, your conversation would just spark. It would just be on fire.
And so, with that being said, are you going to close out the conference for us? Are you going to give us some motivational words and things to look forward to? And
yeah, okay. Yeah. So it's I want to thank everybody for these past 4 weeks. It's been pretty cool to see how this evolved and putting this all together. We couldn't have done it without all the speakers out there, all the Sequoia associates. Thank you. I want to thank our guest speakers, Drew Versa, Ben Matucci. Thank you, Drew, for helping me launch some of the ideas the last 6 months. This is one of those great ideas that came to fruition. So I love it. Thank you, Marisa, for sure. You held everything together. Couldn't have done it without you. You know, you made everything happen, which is great. Thank you. Thank you, Eileen, for being there in the back end, always there to support. Some additional speakers, shout out to Wayman Pang, Jay Green, hopefully I don't forget anybody, Ashley Klein, Sophia Najivi, Brenda Chen, anybody else? Let me know I missed somebody, but always thankful for, again, our team and our support. This been, you know, just, I love how our company, our agents are allowing us to grow. It's great. I get this fuel of energy to do stuff like this, because if our agents weren't supportive of us, Sequoia, there's no way I can put this event on, right? If you look back, like, how can someone do this? How can someone like us do this, right? Who is doing this, right? Who is? But this is just scratching the surface, and you know what next, right? What next? It's the first 10 years. The first 10 years we've been cruising, but I think it's time to take it to another level, right? I think Kalak always used the word rocket ship. So I think that's it. We're not cruising no more. We're gonna take it on this rocket ship, all right? Rocket ship to success. And what am I talking about? Man, the last few days I've been pretty inspired on thinking about what we can do next. And we came together with, and we talk about it all the time in the past few days about keeping each other accountable, putting a plan in motion. So this is it. You know, we're gonna put it out there. We're gonna compete out there. We're going to take this company to the next level. What am I talking about? Well, we're putting together a documentary, a docu-series about Sequoia's growth. All right, from this day forward, we're gonna track this. All right, we're gonna keep, this will keep me accountable. The title of this documentary is The Road to a Billion. That's why you heard it. The Road to a Billion, we're gonna do it. I'm gonna put myself out there. We're gonna push ourselves. We're all gonna do this, okay? And it's time for the world to know who we are. It's time, all right? No more best kept secret. And we're gonna be out there. People are gonna wanna join us, but no, there's a criteria. I wanna make sure they fit our culture, because as we're growing, I want everybody to know that the core right here, our core agents, is what brought us here. And this is my focus, our core agents. And a lot of the growth that I'm shooting for will start from here and continue from here, and we'll still be here. So for sure, this is it. But it's allowed me to open my minds something bigger, where I can see more opportunities. It's kind of funny, as you're getting older, you always think that you're open to ideas, but you're actually not. You get more closed-minded. So I'm trying to bring back my youth from 10 years ago. And with the power of all the energy from you guys behind me, we're going to do this. Okay, roll to a billion. What does it mean? It's $1 billion in sales volume a year. Okay, it's just a number for us to shoot for. Okay, and you can take it as a billionaire. Maybe that will be it. And you know, because if some of you know me, there's this song, one of my favorite karaoke songs. You know, Bruno Mars, Travis McCoy. Billionaire.
Oh, yeah. That's so funny. I was almost gonna play that one. Maybe I'll play that one instead. No. I had a different one, but that one was the set, like, was queued up there too. That's actually funny.
Well, maybe I should leave you on this note. And you know, feel free to chime in, because I wanna be a billionaire.
I'm gonna
so freaking bad. Bala love the things I never had. Sonny, take it.
Serious. Nah,
I want to be on the cover of Forbes magazine.
We got
smiling next to Oprah and the Queen.
Well done, we got
this. Time I close my eyes, I see my name is shining bright. Yeah, different city every night. Oh, I swear. The world better prepare for when I'm a billionaire.
Kelvin's a singer, you guys. There you go. This is our closing out song, guys. I appreciate everybody for being here. Had to play it for Kelvin so he could sort of get on key with it. That was the best. He's singing over there. He's got it. All right. Love it, you guys. It's been my pleasure.
He's got my shirt. He's got my shirt.
He stole your shirt? He stole it? Thank you, guys. Thank you, Sequoia. Thank you, Calvin. Thank you, Eileen. Thank you, everybody. We will have more stuff coming out for you guys. There will be videos from this, and we have some other events. Calvin sort of alluded to it, but we've got more things coming, so excited. Thank you, Jenny. Thank you, Alan. I appreciate all of you guys. I will leave the video up until it's at the end. When it ends, then we'll shut this down and go about the rest of the day. Oh, thank you, Perry. I see my name in a shining light. A different city every night. But now I'm going to play this for Kelvin whenever I see him. In fact, we're going to intro him with this next time on the overlay. So, bye, Brian. Thank you for coming to all of the days. I appreciate you. Thank you so much. All right, guys, have a great rest of your day. Kelvin. Show some personal branding right here. I know we all have a similar dream. Go in your pocket, pull out your wallet, put it in the air and sing. I wanna be a billionaire, so fucking bad. Buy all of the things I never had. I wanna be on the cover of Forbes magazine, smiling next to Oprah and the Queen. What up, Oprah? Oh, every time I close my All right, guys. See you at the next.